Hi, hello, hola, yo, this is Jay, and today we'll see how to measure acceleration values in terms of G with the help of GY61 or ADXL335 accelerometer. So without wasting our time, let's get started. So starting with the connections part, as you can see, the ADXL335 has got 5 pins over here: VCC, X output, Y output, Z output, and the ground pin. So the VCC and ground, as always, are going to connected on the VCC and the ground terminal on the Arduino board, but the ADXL requires only 3.3 volts, so instead of 5 volt, we are going to supply 3.3 volt. And the X, Y, and the Z pins are the pins which are going to measure the acceleration in X, Y, and Z direction. So these three pins will be connected to any of the three analog pins on our Arduino board over here. So for this, I'm going to go for A1, A2, and A3. So let's begin our connections. So that's it, that's the connections part of the ADXL with the Arduino. Simple, right? So our next step is going to be calibration of the sensor. So for that, you will be needing to connect the Arduino board to the PC via our cable. So let's do that, and it is connected. So to calibrate it, we will go to files, we'll open Arduino, we'll go to files, we'll go to examples, sensors, and ADXL3XX series. So since our sensor is 335, it comes under 3XX series, and we'll open this code. So after that, we'll be commenting out few lines which we will not be needing, and we don't need these 4 lines as well. And now we will upload the code. So the code has been uploaded, and we'll go to serial monitor. As you can see, you have started receiving values. So the values I am receiving are 287, 290, 353. Well, these values aren't making any sense, are they? Well, soon enough, we are going to make sense out of them. So what we'll do, we'll just hold the accelerometer . Okay, so now when I hold it flat on the ground surface, you can see the values on the screen are 333, 4, 340, and 277. So if you observe carefully, the first two values lie in the 330 and the 340 range, while the third value is significantly lower than the others, which is 277. So when I hold it flat on the ground, I'm receiving the value as 277. So ignore the first two columns for now, we'll just focus on the third one. And when I hold it exactly upside down, we'll try to hold it still, and the value we are receiving is 410 or somewhere around 411. So what is this indicating? So this is So while you're holding the sensor on the flat surface, the value is 277, which indicates minus g, minus 1g, that is gravity. And while you are holding it exactly the opposite side, the 410 or 411 is indicating the plus 1g value. So basically we are going to map the values between 277 to 411. So 277 indicates minus 1g and 411 indicates 1g. So similarly we need to repeat the procedure for x and y axis as well. So the x and the y axis are given on the downside of the accelerometer, and we'll hold it perpendicular to the ground, and as you can see on the screen we are receiving the values as 331, 272 and 350. So the first and the third column are near to 340's range, while the y-axis is now being the lowest one. So 271 indicates minus 1g, while if I reverse the direction and hold it like this, the value we are receiving is 406. Approximately 406, yes, 405 or 406. So the minus 1g indicates the initial prior value, I just forgot, and 406 indicates 1g. So similarly you need to do it for x-axis as well, this way. Well, it's not necessary that you will be receiving the same values for your sensor, but you need to note down these values. So I have done this multiple times and I have averaged the values, and these are the values I have noted down, and I'll be using it in our code. So let's move to our coding part. And in the starting we define the X pin, Y pin and Z pin as A3, A2 and A1. And then we define the values which we are going to receive as end values. So in the void setup part, we just initialize the serial communication. So coming to our void loop part, well, the first line just measures the values from the X pin and saves it as X value. So our next thing is to map the values between minus 100 to 100. So my lowest values in the X direction were 267 and 400. So 267 corresponds to minus 100 and 400 indicates 100. So in the next line, So in the next line, we will just divide that value by minus 100. So let's say you receive the value as 267. So it will correspond to minus 100, and here it will get divided by minus 100. So basically you will receive the value as 1g, and then we print the value in g. So that's it, and we have repeated the same thing twice for the y and the z values. So let's upload the code. And we'll open the serial monitor and see what are the values we are getting. So here are the values. So I'm going to hold it flat initially to the ground surface, and let's see what are the values we are getting. So the values we are getting are 0.0g in x direction, minus 0.02g in y direction, and minus 1g in the z direction. So minus 1g indicates in the direction of ground. So now we will hold it in the y axis and what are the values. So in x direction it's 0.03 or 04, it's a little bit tilted I guess, and so it is showing that value. And in the y direction it's 1g, and in the z direction it's almost 0g. So that's it. So let's say that you want to plot a graph of these values. So it's very simple to do. Well, we just need to make a few changes in the code. So we will comment out the print G values. And enter the new line here. And that's it. So you need to make sure that you have got the latest version of the Arduino. I do have it here. And then we'll upload the code. After that, go to Tools and click on Serial Plotter. So as you can see, the Serial Plotter has started plotting the values. And now, as always, we will hold the accelerometer still. And you can see that the green line is representing the acceleration in the Z direction, and it is indicating as minus 1G. So if I hold it in inverted position, exactly upside down, you will see that again the X and Y are showing as 0G and the Y has shifted to plus 1G. So as I increase the angle, you can see that the Y keeps on increasing to 1G and also the Z keeps on increasing from minus 1 to 0G. This way you can plot a graph as well. So that's all for today, guys. I hope you found the video helpful. If you like this video, then please leave us a like below. In my next video, we are going to apply a simple trick through which you can measure the tilt or angle with the help of same accelerometer we used here. So make sure you subscribe. Until then, adios, sayonara, goodbye, bye bye.